Anyway, this is your girl Joy back with another bang on honey. Purr, purr. Come on in, come on in, come on in. How you doing? Ooh, child, it's hot up here. You see my little sweatshirt? Baby daddy got me this sweatshirt. I know, you know, I'm not promoting the drink, but you. So anyway, how y'all doing? You okay, baby? You okay? So, ooh, I just got home from work and baby, I had to put my little foot up. Ooh, my foot is doing a little better. I will say it's doing a little better. I tried to walk a little normal today, but ooh, I put that pressure on it and then somebody hit my toe at school. Baby. And my principal looks at me like, I said, don't worry about it, mister. Don't worry about it, and I just keep hopping along. I've learned to hop along a little faster though. So the girls did not go to school today. I think because their school was testing or something. So I don't know, hopefully we had issues with the state standardized test, so the kids didn't test on Tuesday. It was a hot mess, child. So I guess hopefully the Education Association figured that stuff out. I just finished vlogging about activity I created for the kids on my teacher channel. So I designed this, but everything was based on the textbook. So I created this foldable and it matches and mimics what's in the textbook, but I wanted to make it visually appealing and for the kids to color it in and blah blah blah. So I worked on that, so I'm super excited to give that to them. Probably won't start that until after they take their state standardized test next Tuesday. I knew both the girls were staying home, right? So I knew they were staying home and I was like, so in the morning. So I was like, well, maybe you guys could, you know, put the treadmill together. It's together, just the screws won't go in. So we have to loosen the other screws to try to shove another piece in, whatever. And I said, and finish painting my little thing that's in the garage. That'll be helpful. Because I feel like nobody goes out of their way to do stuff for me. But then I feel like I'm always going out of my way to do stuff for them. So I was like, okay, can y'all finish painting it? You know, can you at least put the treadmill? Because, you know, before my foot happened, I was in the process of trying to put it back together. And then it didn't work. So, of course, I came home second time this week. Not done. I mean, sometimes it just hurts my feelings. And then again, then I'm like, they didn't ask to be here. But I don't know. I'm probably bugging, right? I'm probably wrong. You know, you just feel like maybe, you know, they want to do something. Doesn't cost any. I don't know. But I was just in my feelings a little bit. I was like, dang. I was like, this is it. And the last couple of days, I've been so tired. And like, it's late right now too, y'all. Yeah, it's 10:37. And then I'm getting ready to shower. Then crawl in bed. Then snooze my alarm 50,000 times in the morning. But I'm gonna try to get to school early because I got stuff I need to. No, I probably gotta do one thing before I go to sleep. It just never stops for a teacher. And it really annoys me when people be like, oh, teachers get summers off. Even in the summertime, we're working on our lesson plans for the next year. We're doing all this training because we have to have a certain number of hours of training every year. So we try to get it all in the summertime. So it's like it really doesn't end when most people think it ends. It really doesn't. We work nonstop. So in the 10 months that we work enough for about a year and a half within those 10 months. Because baby, I can tell you, I can leave school and I'll come home, do whatever, twirl around, and I still have schoolwork. You know, so it burns my biscuits when somebody says, well, you guys get summers off, you get this off. Baby, we work hard. And then you have a group of teachers who don't. But I know the team, the school I work with, my people I work with, we work hard. We work hard. And some people are like, don't work hard, work smart. We work. I know I always do because my brain is always going on. My brain just like this. Did I really have to do this? No, but y'all know I can't help myself. I'm just not gonna do anything regular. That's just not gonna happen no matter what. If I'm making a burger, honey, I'm gonna add a twist to the burger. It's just the way my brain works. I cannot help myself. I just can't. And so I'm never gonna do anything just regular. It's just not in my DNA, I guess. It's just, oof, sometimes it's, ooh. Anyway, so listen back to my story. But I guess maybe, you know, I should not. Well, I don't expect anything. I really don't. Not from my kids. Not from my kids. But I'm just like, sometimes it would be nice. Let's say sometimes maybe I come home and my room has been scrubbed and vacuumed and mopped and, you know. And this is another reason why I don't get excited over Mother's Day at all. Because I feel as though Mother's Day should be every day. Every day. You know, that one time a year everybody wants to go off and celebrate and do extra. Or a little bit, just a little something. No, I feel as though why? It should be every day. All the sacrifices and things I've done for, but they didn't ask to be here, so, you know, you know, you just think that they'll, anyway, maybe I'm just bugging. I don't know, y'all. Y'all let me know in the comments. I'm just, Julie, you bugging. I don't know, but it's like what my mom, I remember when I started working, and whenever she asked me to do something, I did it. She didn't have to ask me twice. And she didn't ask for much. And then every birthday, she was the only person I bought stuff for. So it was just like, but I always wanted her to be happy when I was, you know, when I got my little job. You always gave her money out of my paycheck. I don't know if that was the older generation we did that. And I did have this conversation with Bob. She was like, oh, so what are you saying? You want money? And I was like, no, you only work 2 days a week. And she will pay for a lot of her own stuff. Sydney will not. She won't. And Sydney's not really working out anyway, so she don't have nothing. But Bobby, she works. She paid for her prom dress. She paid for so many things. She's paying to get her hair done. So she has helped out a great deal in that sense. So now I'm trying to look for a little cash card for her, y'all. A little cash card. So if y'all have any suggestions where I could look for a little cash card, so I'm trying to save my little stimulus money, but I keep picking off of that just for day-to-day living. The end of the month be rough, child. So just trying to hurry up and get her a little cash card before she leaves for school. So this April major, so she only has about 2 more months here, and I keep telling her to work on her Amazon school list, things that she needs for school. But oh my god, listen. So she was nominated to be student of the year at her school, but then she needed a community leader to give her recommendation. So she got her 2 letters of recommendation, and her AAU basketball coach, he has his own league. It's his AAU league, and he wrote such a wonderful letter a recommendation for her. Oh, it was really, really, really nice. You know, I did want to edit it a little bit, but it was a PDF. So, but it was so beautiful what he wrote about her and how we all saw something in her. And a lot of people just believed in her with the basketball and stuff and everything that she does. And so sometimes you can see something in somebody. And I feel as though my very first principal was like that. You know, I'll always love her. My very first principal, she saw something in me, and she believed in me when I had 0 experience. And although, you know, I was probably bamboozled because it was to work at a behavior school. But anyway, I didn't know any difference. It was just a job going into my new dream. So it's nice when people can see things in you that you may not even see for yourself, and they still believe in you and they still encourage you and not try to tear you down. And then there is one girl, a black girl, honey, black girl, at my school. Not many of us there. She really has, I don't want to say she surprised me, but I've had so many haters in my life, and you know, people try to tear you down, that when I don't get that from her, it just makes my heart smile. It makes me happy because I was like, oh God, now she gonna start hating on me. And then she doesn't. And she was like, you always inspire, Bazzle. You always inspire. So she always has something positive to say or something encouraging to say. And it does warm my heart. Because, you know, with the younger people, I'm like, oh, God, now we got another hate. She could be hating on me. Oh, my God. And I ain't do nothing. It's just that some people don't want to see you shine or whatever. But I don't get that from her. And it just makes me so excited and happy that I don't. And I wanted to write her a little letter thanking her for that because, baby, I've gotten a business pretty much all my life. So it's just a nice little change to have that positivity that's constantly there at work. So anyway, I just wanted to tell you guys that and let me know what you think. Am I bugging with it's like I don't expect it. But it's like you do so much. And like when I ask. And I don't ask for much at all. So when I was like, you know, can somebody finish paint? Because it has paint on it. But I realized I don't like painting stuff like that. So I was like, can y'all at least finish painting it for me? Blah, blah, blah. You know, when they asked me to leave school early because they got to run errands, they need my car. I'm rushing out of school knowing that there are other things I could still be doing. Then I come home. Then I'm doing it at home. So I was like, whether they need something, whatever it is, it's just like, I ask for something very rare. It's rare. Well, you know, it's always the kitchen. But it just hurts my feelings sometimes. Like, nobody really goes out their way for me. You know, I'm talking about the kids. So it just hurts my feelings. So, you know, that's what I always tell you guys before. Pretend like you're hearing it for the first time. I feel like the giving tree and all my leaves are gone. And then when I ask for something, nobody has time. Nobody has time for what I need or what I want. But anyway, as you all know, the ones who know me and love me, for my new people, my daughter, Bobby, she's amazing. Sydney's amazing. Clinton, all three of them are amazing in their own way. But they're great kids. I really can't complain in that area either too much. You know, Clinton had his moment of laziness. It was really laziness, but he was a good kid. He is a good kid. So, but he's getting it together, y'all. Got his two jobs and about to transfer to Blinn College or something like that. And then he'll think about his next step, where he wants to go next. So he's doing his thing. He's doing really well. He's into stocks now, selling and buying stocks. You know, you can do penny stocks and stuff too, but he's into it. He should show me a screenshot of his computer screen. I didn't understand any of that. I was like, brr, brr, numbers everywhere. He was like, oh yeah, this is easy. Clinton is actually the smartest in the house. He was the smartest. He was a smart baby. We thought he was a baby genius, honey. He knew 50 sign, and I taught him sign language. I really put a lot and invested a lot of time and energy. He's smart. He's naturally smart. Bobby has an amazing work ethic that enables her to be smart. And Sydney, she's a smart girl. So, you know, they all have their different levels of smartness, okay? Let's just say. So, the great kids. So, I'm going to take a shower now. And, I think I'm ready to print and be ahead of the game for next Wednesday. Oh, listen. This is the last thing for real. What's this? When is it? Next Wednesday, Bobby has her commitment ceremony at a high school where she has to wear the college shirts. I guess all the kids who got scholarships are going off to college to play ball or to play their sport, whatever the sport is. They have a huge signing ceremony for all the kids who are going off to continue playing in the sport that they played in high school. So it's a huge signing ceremony that she has on Wednesday. moms, and she was like, Mom, you have to be there. You got to be there. I was like, no problem. And listen. Remember, I told you about the prom dress, how I want her to be different. Well, you know, like with peacock feathers and stuff flying everywhere, right? Like a little globe around or whatever. And she didn't want to do that, but she did get a cute dress. Her dress is cute. Looked like it was made for her. So anyway. And there was a dress that I sent her years ago. I was like, Bobby, I want you to do this. I want you to do this. Bobby, can you do this? You'll be beautiful. So that's not what she wants to do, which is fine. But guess who's going to do it? Yes, honey. It's going to be, I'm going to be like coming to America at her graduation, honey. I'm even going to get me a little Afro wig. I don't know if these braids can last a whole nother month. I'm gonna give me a big Afro wig, honey. She can be cute. And my little, I'm not gonna give it away, but I'm gonna be coming to America up in the Woodlands, honey. And there's not many of us in the Woodlands, honey. Yes. I'm gonna slay. And you know I gotta make up from Clinton's graduation that he didn't do, and my graduation that I didn't do, and now hers, baby. Maybe I'll just walk on stage just to walk on a stage. Bam! Coming to America. I can't wait. I got the vision in my head. And you know, I don't mind. I'll break out a sewing machine and create my own creation, hunty. I got a whole month to work on it. Yes. It's graduation. Mama did that. Yes, she did. I mean, they did the work, but, you know, I was by the side and stuff. So I just feel like, you know, it's my graduation too. Especially with Clint, honey. Baby, I sat in his classes. And I said, if you keep acting up in this class, I'm gonna snatch my wig off. I sat right in the back of the room. All day. But that's kind of dumb anyway, because I'm not going to act the while mama's there and she done threatened to snatch her wig off in your class. So that was kind of, I should have showed up in a robe with rollers in my hair. Maybe he would have went to graduation this year. He would have been afraid. Very afraid. But baby, that's okay. Mama's going to do it because why? Because that's what I want to do. Let me be proud. And let me be me. Give us free. Coming to America. Coming your way soon, baby. I'm about to slay, baby. Slay. I may have baby daddy put roses while I'm walking so I can walk upon the roses in front of me and I can step. Step on the roses. Step. My feet would not touch concrete. My feet only touch the rose. And step in and walk in and walk. Yes, I'm gonna be coming to America in the Woodlands. Baby, they ain't gonna know what happens. Did Africa come here? Boom, boom. Boom, boom. You know, have the African drums playing in the background too. Show out in the Woodlands. Karen may say, what in the world is going on here? Is this allowed? Tom, can we get something? Can we do something about this? We are not in Africa, Tom. Tom better have several seats because the bass is going to show the hell out. Oh, yeah.